My name is Clement Ubriyeboa. I'm the Vice President of Apologetics and Leadership Institute. Charles Wesley once said, "The Lord buries his workmen, but his work continues." It's very unfortunate that I'm doing this at this age of my life. It's so hard for me to believe that the person whom in my confusing years, when I was having doubts about my faith, I met him and he helped me to understand my faith.
I am Frederick, the Executive Secretary of Apologetic and Leadership Institute. Elder is a father, one that has transformed my life. His act of discipline and his mentorship has been one that marvels me.
Today, he's no more. I received a call on the 6th of June, that was a Thursday in the morning, around 11 from Reverend Kalai, and he broke the news to me. I was a bit doubtful because I had spoken to Elder a day before. So I told him that I'll make some calls to confirm because he said it was a rumor. So I called Elder's number, he didn't pick up. I called his in-law, I called his wife. All these people didn't pick up. So I called his younger brother who is in Ghana, and he told me that he has not heard anything. And after some few minutes, people were sending messages to ask if that is true. So I called the numbers again. I sent messages, no one was responding. So I called his younger brother back to tell him to tell him what I've heard. And he told me it's true. He had said it early in the morning, but he couldn't tell me when I called because we were all hoping that it was false. So I also told him, no, even though you've confirmed it, but I don't think it's true. But unfortunately, the news was true. My beloved, my father in the Lord, Elder Emmanuel Amissah, was no more. Wow, such a vibrant and knowledgeable young man is gone. What can we say?
He does something and tells you, get it done in the next 2 minutes. He gives you a book to read and tells you, give me a report by evening. He does something and his ability to monitor, mentor and direct you is so marvelous.
I got in touch with Ademis, I think somewhere 2017-2018. Now may apologetics is one institution be. But me share Ademis as an elder, not only so yeah elder by then, and my your bond near so strong. And now, Mr. Hoon said, now, only me Pensa Vice President, and some quasi, and Pensa Vice President, Eddie, me Juan Dancy. Now, my sister, and so Dickness, Felicia, so dear, and so Juan Dancy, Jeremy, Tiamma. Naturally, your bond will be so tight. And Emma may prepare for ministerial interview, grand. Question be a yet trickly, be enough to get in touch with him as a big brother. So, that way, no, it's then or church. We could be on the phone for more than an hour. And now, if you want me topic, be a me person, go cast on so that my friend said, senior, we boy, I'm united saying, OTS, and then he'll bring his view. He has been like a big brother, as a friend. Oh, no, no. We could chat at night at any time, be awfully free.
Bible says death is a gain to the believer. Even just as Revelation says, when the righteous dies, we go to rest. Elder Emmanuel Amissah, the apologist, I met with him 2 years ago on Facebook. From there, we exchanged contacts and we built communication. Elder Emmanuel Amissah has been a blessing. And I happen to be on one of his WhatsApp platforms where discussions, mentorship and teachings are being given by him and other people he brings on board on Christian apologetics and doctrines. Elder Emmanuel Amissah, indeed the body of Christ here on this present earth, we have lost a great gem, but we know heaven has gained. Though his life has been very short, but his impact is tremendous.
He is someone that transcends our generation and forever will be remembered for what he has come to do. He has paid his dues, and we are saddened to be informed about this unfortunate event.
In the term of the drunk as well, no, about Bible school, PCC. Once in a while, I get in touch and that says it. Now, on to ne group now, what in I'm part of the group. Every Tuesday, be an hour, you have one book, na you have for the affirm. And anytime, be or treat any particular course, heresies, be a. I joined material be or Kasawa TV, so another particular platform not about material be done my chatting. And I will need that book when I send him. We want to see how his ministry going.
Scripture says in 1 Thessalonians 4:16, the Lord Himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. I don't know where to begin, because the death of my dear brother, Elder Emmanuel Amissah, came as a great shock to me and my family. This is a painful departure that I can't really comprehend. Only the good Lord Himself, He knows why He has called Adamisa at such a time like this. I met Adamisa through one of his discussions on Facebook, where he mentioned a book titled The Pagan Christianity. So after that, listening to him, I bought the book and I took a picture of it and shared with him. He replied me immediately on Facebook, and the friendship began from there.
I met Elder Amissah not quite long ago, but because of his impact, it seems like it's over 10 years. I actually ran into him on Facebook and then on Buck TV. It was at a time that I was asked a question during the evangelism that I ran into one Ubejistani young lady who told me that after a long conversation, and he seemed like she's convinced, and she's like, but I cannot depend on an outdated document. That was where it dawned on me that I need more in order to be able to be a faithful witness of the Lord Jesus. And that was just around the time I met him on social media. And it has been a very good journey. And we are more like a family.
Before I became born again, I had some simple but tough questions about Christianity, about the concept of God, and about Jesus Christ. So when I became a Christian, and for that matter, a minister of the gospel, I realized that there may be a lot of people with the same mindset as I used to, having the same questions. So I decided to study and to do research in order to find answers to these questions so that I can help others to gain answers to those questions, and also to help my members to be able to understand the faith that they have joined, and then to understand Jesus whom they are following very well. So once I started studying and doing research on this, I came upon Elder Emmanuel Amissah from Vogue TV when he was handling a program called Who is Disturbing the Church. So I realized that he's having the information that can propel me to achieve my desire. So I contacted him and then we started communicating. So I joined his class, ELI, that is the Apologetics and Leadership Institute. So I took some courses, he recommended some books, and then we became close. So even before his demise, a week before his demise, we spoke on phone and we arranged to meet. He told me that he has prepared some materials about church growth that will help me to build my church. So we are supposed to meet. And then even apart from that, he was doing Facebook Live with the Good News Apologetic. And then I was joining throughout. So the last day that I did not join was when I opened my phone and I saw on Facebook that Elda is no more.
My name is Elda Gilbert Babon. Talking about the incident of the Emissah today, I never thought that this is what I'll be talking about him. I never thought. I was thinking that maybe if I'll be talking about something concerning him, it will be about the usual teachings he does give me.
Apart from being a member of the ALI, Elder takes special interest in my family life. We discuss a lot of things. And during the week before his departure, we spoke about so many things. He gave me a personal prophecy. I never knew that was going to be the last thing I'll ever hear from him.
He's someone that transcends our generation and forever will be remembered for what he has come to do. He has paid his dues. We are saddened to be informed about this unfortunate event.
In the time of the drunk as well, no, about Bible school, PCC. Once in a while, I get in touch and that says it. Now, on the group now, what I'm part of the group. Every Tuesday, be an hour for one book. Now, yeah, for the affirm. And now, anytime be or treaty any particular course heresies be I joined material be or Kasawa TV so and any particular platform not about material be done my chatting. And I will need that book when I send him. Woman will see how his ministry going. Now last year during missions week, and one pastor be Epe will be na Wakasa for internal missions in the Church of Principles within Ghana, missionary or mission area. One of the Mr. a charter me said, person may link you Emma one pastor be. Now, Kasa for internal missions. So, wow, such a great opportunity. It has opened a lot of avenues through that. Now, major preparation towards that in Pune. And then, Mr. me prepare material ni we Let me prepare my slides. Let me just change. You know, so there be you away from you away from far away. Come once you say we're home here. No guiding me. At the end of the day, the presentation was okay. Now, even on the eve of the presentation, the Mr. Frame. Now, what data? So, what data? Now, who is MTN out there? Now, the Mr. I think he sent me 150 or 200 CDs. So, me fans, but in front of data.
So, we will have to carry on with whatever we benefited from him, his ministry, to make impact in the body of Christ. One of his programs he does on Bob TV has been a great blessing, which I often even make my church members to watch Sundays after church. One thing I love about Elder Emissah is the pace at which he make explanations, the simplicity and the clarity that comes with him addressing matters and issues. And that is exceptional with him. May the Lord give him eternal rest until we meet again. May the Lord comfort the wife he has left behind and the family. And may the Lord also comfort we all and all the members of ALI. Rest in peace, Elder Emmanuel Amissah.
And it is still working. And Emmanuel Amissah defend the faith with a sense of passion, love, and humility. I have never seen him defend the faith by insult or in an harsh way. He wants everything to be done according to the book, which is the scriptures. And losing him, to me personally, I have lost a great thing, because we are working some things together which we are not yet done, and death has taken my brother and my friend. But I know he's in the bosom of our Maker.
I'm still struggling to come to terms that he's no more. Especially today being a Saturday that we usually have our program, ALI Euro branch, I should call it. I'm still struggling to believe that he's no more. But I know God loves him more than we do. And so we take comfort in God's word, in Isaiah 57 verse 1 and 2. And we trust that the Lord himself will help us continue. He declared the month of June as the month of the Holy Spirit. Probably he was telling us to depend on the Holy Spirit for his empowerment and his endowment to continue what the Lord led him to begin with us.
So I was so shocked to the extent that for about 3 minutes I was looking on the phone. I was not talking, like nothing was going through my mind. As to whether it is true or not, nothing was going through my mind. So about 3 days I just decided not to believe it, until I realized that the information and the people who are bringing out the information are authentic. But I realized that it is up to God. You know, it looked as if Elder himself knew that he was about to depart, because he made it in a such a way that he pushed all the people that were with him to take that position, to take that position that he was taking. For example, even when we were doing the Facebook Live with Good News Apologetic, I realized that he was pushing Elder Clement to speak more. And then even when we meet as ALI, he gives the platform for people to lead, which means that he did all he has to do. To me, I know that the information I needed, he has given me.
My first time I met Edemisa was around 2013. That's about 11 years ago. Back at Wa, when he was doing his first degree, and I was also doing my first degree, and then being a Catholic, a devout Catholic, nobody preached to me about the gospel, but something was like, I should go to the Church of Pentecost. It was like I lacked something. I should go to the Church of Pentecost. I should go to the Church of Pentecost. Something was just clicking to me that if the thing that you lack, go to the Church of Pentecost. If you go to the Church of Pentecost, you will get it. So I followed that voice. I went to the Church of Pentecost. And when I went, I met this young guy who was very vibrant. And in fact, they handed me to him. And they handed other new convert to him. And he taught us the new convert class. When he finished teaching us the new convert class, it didn't end there. Those of us that he taught that during that 2013 there. So the way he was so aggressive with me, within 2 weeks, I got Holy Ghost baptism. When I got the Holy Ghost baptism, something dawned on me that this is what you were looking for. And I had a peace of mind. And this young man, he didn't just leave us, but he put some of us together who were willing to learn and pray with him, and we formed the prayer tower group. And in that prayer tower group, we're always praying for the church, we're always praying for the leadership, we're always praying for, and even in Ghana, and then we were never blind. Whatever that was coming concerning the church, we always knew it. And as if that was not all, he started to call us the students of the Bible. I didn't know the students of the Bible. And he started to coach us. From his coaching, he made me to develop interest in studying the Bible. And I think he was the first person who led me to learn the Bible.
Through my talk with him and relationship with him, I realized, oh, my brother was very, very knowledgeable. He had deep insight into scriptures. And I admired his passion and his depth of thought. So I told him, my brother, you can't keep this to yourself. So let's do something. And he asked me to create a WhatsApp group. And all of a sudden, COVID came. So during COVID, we started this online apologetics group, and he made me the admin of the group and also created Zoom account and setting up email addresses to support him and sharing resources with people that are joined the group. In fact, my experiences and relationship with him really changed my life. It changed my perspective about scriptures, and it really shaped my Christian life as well. I was always looking forward to meet Edamisa. So in 2022, my family went for a visit in Ghana, and I made sure that whatever it is, wherever he is, I'll go together with my family and meet him. And that was one of the exciting moments, and it strengthened our bond of friendship. Our friendship grew stronger and stronger. Then at a point in time, it became like a family. My wife always reached out to him. He could reach out to us anytime. So when I was preparing to go for the Pentecost conference in Germany, I reached out hoping that we could meet there once again to reconnect, but he couldn't make it. Then all of a sudden, his news came to me about his death. And this death has kept me to be very sober. I haven't gathered enough courage to talk about this death. In fact, the messages that I've received are intentionally, and I've refused to talk about it. Elder, your passing is really a shock to me. You stood for the Lord you have the courage to stand and defend the gospel. I know the Lord knows best. You serve Him well. You have influenced and touched many lives. And I know that the Lord has welcomed you in a good place. And you will be crowned with a crown of rejoicing. Rest well, my brother, and soldier on in eternity. Amen.
What can we do? We can do nothing. But we take solace in the word of God. That says that when we die in the Lord, we go to rest from our labor. And we know that Elder Emmanuel Amissah has gone ahead of us to rest from his labor. And at the right time, when God brings us together, we will see him and we all shall rejoice.
But wherever he is, we continue the mantle and we thank him for the very few years he spends with us and the transformed lives he has left. And that which we continue, we pray the Lord gives us the strength to accept it and move on. He is gone, but he's still with us. And forever will be remembered.
It's very hard, it's very devastating to lose such a young man. The apologetics fraternity in Ghana has lost a gem, has lost an icon who was going to rise up to change the face of apologetics in Ghana, in Africa, and in the world. But it's unfortunate. So that we may also die whilst we remain faithful to the Lord. Thank you very much.